Whoa! I expect more of these guys. Okay, just killed some big things. Now I'm gonna run through the gate. The last episode seemed to have ended kind of abruptly. I'm pretty sure that my game just crashed on me. It's an unfortunate fact of playing old games. It doesn't always work on new operating systems, but, you know, it is what it is. Let's move on. No, go through it. There we go. Oh, yay. Another one of these. Moving through the temples, just reusing environments. That's all that we're doing here. Who wants to pick a fight with me now? Come on now. I'll take you all on, you bitches. Isn't even anyone here. He's trying to kill me. Is this where I came from? Jeez, it's been a unfortunately, it's been about 2 weeks since I got a chance to play any of this game, so I've kind of lost track of where I was. It sucks. I don't even know if I'm supposed to be here or not. Shit. Should I be starting this episode over again? Oh, man. I forget even what I was supposed to be getting. Shit. Damn it. Stupid backwards shit. What? That's so... I mean, not entirely the game creator's fault. But one flaw I will say that there is in this game... There we go.
A new area of the Vampire Citadel lay open. I still had much to discover.
Oh, so I did do the right thing.
Nestled deep in the Black Forest, Vorador had once held court over a private kingdom, as decadent as it was depraved. Now all was still. I hoped I had not arrived too late.
Wow, look at this place. Pretty amazing to believe this was supposed to be a PlayStation 2 game. I mean, this is a PC version I'm playing, but still. The environments and all that kind of stuff would have stayed the same. But yeah, it's pretty good detail, at least from a distance. Vorador was the vampire that slaughtered the Circle of the Nine. Or the Pillars, the Nine Pillar Guardians in the beginning of the game, Blood Omen. And was essentially like this very old vampire who... Hold on. He's this very old vampire that was, as we understand now, the oldest of the human vampires. Cain, when he first met him, reacted kind of not verbally, didn't want to give himself away, he saw the order of his health, but was kind of disgusted with what he saw when he encountered Vorador. Either that was a result of Vorador's weird fertility. like, cavalier attitudes, life in general, although I doubt that. It was probably as a result, though, of Vorador's almost, like, hyper-realistic attitude towards Kane really shouldn't be talking to us smack, considering he at one point referred to Vorador's pantry of humans as being glorious. But Kane didn't get Vorador at all, but he himself killed Malak of the Seraphim for the Vorador. Vorador was encountered again in the kingdom. It was a very different situation. Instead of keeping the lunatic, he was just after his own pleasures and all that kind of stuff. Malak had a... not Malak. very different person. Vorador had a gone... sort of become a much more of like a fathering figure or a mentoring figure for the vampires of the world, and was disgusted at the idea that Kane had gone and killed someone that he had cared about. Even before, he wouldn't have cared about anybody, although he did take a certain interest in Kane, saying it would be a shame if someone so young were to go and get himself killed. And the Vorador that we should encounter at this time period should be the hedonistic lunatic, though. He hasn't had time to... whatever change it was that would have changed his attitude. Ah, crap, I gotta phase through this. I changed my button mapping, though, so you gotta give me a sec to figure out exactly what I did wrong here. I'd forgotten that I had mapped both the keypad and the gamepad, so... weird. Hello? That was unnecessary, but, whatever. What a depressing bunch of shit you'll hear in the spectral realm. The layout that we're seeing here does not much... oh, that thing's definitely gonna attack me. The layout doesn't look much like the Vorador Mansion in the game Blood Omen, even though it's clearly supposed to be the same place. Hello. These are more of the zombies. Now, when we encounter the move through Vorador's mansion in Blood Omen, it wasn't occupied by these kinds of things. It was more of they're mostly vampires that Kane encountered, not zombies or demons. Kane was actually forced to kill his way through quite a few vampires in order to get the Vorador. One of the few occasions where other vampires were seen in that game. I think it also made a mention that maybe there might have been human slaves, but don't quote me on that one. I think I might be making that up. Weird, the staircase goes nowhere. Shit, what was I doing? A doorway opened somewhere, didn't it? Oh, look at that. Oh, here we go. Such big hallways. Of course, realistically, you'd expect that there have to be big hallways in the game, because small hallways would mean that there wasn't much room for the character to move around through the camera that could flip through environments and all that kind of stuff. Which ruined the gameplay experience in a lot of ways. But, I mean, playing the game and looking at it, it kind of seems kind of weird that the Vorador would have these huge empty hallways. Looks like game level design is kind of weird. I would say that the level design in this game is kind of pretty indicative of what gameplay design was back in the early 2000s when this game was made. Because, I mean, in modern gameplay design, you wouldn't, for example, have this one door opening off into a hallway which runs down this direction and turns left for no frickin' reason. I bet if I could look at a layout of this map, there would be no rooms on the side of this hallway on either side. It wouldn't... not a realistic way of constructing a building. Oh, it's gonna be dangerous. Hello? Oh. Hold on. Oh, that's right. I'm not Kane right now. I can't do that. I gotta do this manually. Ah, get back over here. Be quick about it. There we go. Ooh, magic.
This pool seemed related to the portals which had transported me into the vampire ruins, but its surface was disturbed by the spouting of these gargoyles.
Ah, damn you tentacles moving through rock and all. Tell somebody who put their heart and soul into this, game design. I mean, look at these rooms that we're going through and all that kind of stuff. Although I questioned Raziel's interpretation, portals are related. It's the Stargate-looking things that got him into the room. I don't see that guy anymore. It's a video game. Damn you if you only had wings. Not quite. There we go. What? Why'd you make it dark for me to play? Whatever. Just know to stay away. Why is there so much?
This mural was similar to one I had seen before in the fountain room.
Matter, Raziel, no commentary on what you're seeing? Oh, shit! It's the corpse of a vampire, but an ancient vampire. He's got wings and shit. But maybe I killed him. It's hard to tell. You know what? I'm gonna see the vampire design right here. All decomposed and shit. Probably the same. I thought you were dead. Well, you will be soon. Thank you. Why would a vampire Vorador have so much water in his dwelling? I mean, vampires, even older ones like Vorador, are dangerously, like, they die when they touch water. I mean, so it just seems like a dangerous thing. What do they drink other than blood? You know, blood has a lot of water in it. So, whatever. Ah, shit, here we go again. Of course, you can't swim in the spectral realm, so we have to walk along the bottom. Get down here so I can kill you. Gotta be a way out. Clearly some sort of flooded crypt. Alright, then I guess maybe the, telekinesis my way through that later. Maybe this is just accidental that, Vorador had his, shit. Had his, mansion flooded a little bit. I guess there wouldn't really be anything to do about it, would there? I hear a portal around here somewhere. I can't find it. I better find it soon. I'm just running around like an idiot. I'm an idiot. You can climb up things in the spectral realm in this game. Another discrepancy between the earlier games. In Soul Reaver, you couldn't climb anything in the spectral realm like that. You had to get it back in the material realm.
This door clearly required some artifact before it would open.
Yes, clearly. Here we go. Moving on. No, maybe not that way. Is there anything down here for me? Oh. Ah, that's right. I can't do anything. I can't, telekinesis my way through any of this shit. I can't attack, so I'm not getting through that just yet. Hello, what are you doing here? So I've ordered to keep a lot of people locked up in his, mansion. No sense on me doing anything about it. And another one of those. Is that a switch? Oh, looks like we're getting to a more hot portion. With all of these barrels and shit. Oh, what a weird layout. Well, we're coming up on 20 minutes, so I'm gonna be bringing this episode to a close. So, oh shit, don't torture the locked up. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to kill you like that. You're probably an innocent person. But whatever, you know. Should have been smart enough not to get captured. Oh shit, another one.